Hola amigos, ¿cómo están? ¿Qué pasa? Today we're getting ready for 5 de Mayo, a big celebration in Mexico. And we are actually gonna make a little flor de Mexico. I'm gonna teach you how to make the paper flower. We did this el año pasado en mi clase, so you probably remember perfectly well how to do this. Just in case, I wanted to show you again how you can make this very easily in casa, at home. So, what you need to make our pretty flor is going to end up looking sort of like this. You are going to go look for some tissue paper. Papel que se ve así. It's that fine tissue-ish paper that we put in our bags when we give away presents. So, whatever colores you have, no importa. In Mexico, we tend to have really bright colors, colores brillantes. Today, in my closet, I only, where I keep my present stuff, I only found kind of pastel colors, but that works fine too. So, you're gonna need tres papeles. The size is gonna be about yay big. It's probably about half the size of a real big square, so it's going to turn out to be un rectángulo. You need tres colores. I usually like to have three different colores because it just looks prettier. So yes, my papel is a little wrinkly here, but that's okay. I think it'll work. I'm going to use un verde, and I'm going to use un blanco, and I am going to use rosado. See? I'm gonna line them up real carefully, and I see that one of them is actually not exactly the same size as the other ones. So then if I were you, I would go ahead and cut so that we make sure that we have el mismo tamaño. Otherwise, they're not gonna line up real well. There. So we have papeles, we have tijeras. And if you have green pipe cleaners at home, perfecto, because it's gonna be our stem of the flor, but it's not importante that they be green. So if you have any other color, that works fine too. Muy bien, so now I'm gonna put the other papeles away so you can see mejor, a little better, what I'm doing. So I'm gonna line up my papeles beautifully straight like this, and I'm gonna turn the short side to me. And now I'm gonna ask my camera woman to come behind me so that you can see exactly how I fold. So I'm gonna start at the bottom and I'm gonna fold arriba, upwards, about an inch. And I'm gonna press down really well, almost like I'm ironing, planchando the papel. Now I'm going to grab with my dedos in the corners, and I'm gonna flip it like a pancake, like that. And then I am going to fold the same exact size abajo. Now I'm going to hold on to the corners again, flip it like a pancake, and now I'm back here, I'm gonna go arriba. Press down hard, duro. Hold on to the corners, flip it like a pancake, and now I'm gonna go abajo. Panqueque, arriba. Panqueque, abajo. Panqueque, arriba. Panqueque, abajo. Panqueque, arriba. And if they don't line up perfectly at the end, just fold it in as best as you can like that, so that they all kind of line up. Muy bien, make sure you fold them like this. Muy bien. Qué bonito. Now I'm going to take my pipe cleaner, and I'm already, before I put it on, I'm gonna kind of see where my medio, la mitad is right there. See how that's middle? And I am going to put that just like that. And I'm gonna try to find la mitad, the center, el centro. Do you think that looks good? Is that the center? Perfecto. Now you're going to twist. Vuelta, vuelta. Now, you don't want this to be too tight, but you don't want it to be too loose either, because then your papel will slide on out. So just make sure that it's nice and firm and yet not too tight. Twist your stem, and now we're going to end up with something that looks like that. Now I'm going to take my tijeras, and I am going to, you can cut a tip here if you want to, like a triangulo, that works too. I think I'll try that this time. With that one, I cut like a half moon up here. Do you see how it has rounded petalos? This time I'm going to see what it looks like if I cut un triangulo. So I'm just going to cut like a little mountain, una montaña up there. And lo mismo aquí. Así. It doesn't have to be perfecto. We do what we can. I put my tijeras back, my basura up there. Make sure you take care of your basura. All right. Now, it looks like it's not exactly in the center. I want it exactamente in the centro. That's mejor. All right. Now we're going to fold out this to become un círculo. Así, you don't need tape or anything like that. Don't get the tape. And now what I'm going to do is, I'm con mucho cuidado, I'm going to take one color at a time, una color a la vez. And I'm con mucho cuidado, gently going to pull it up towards el centro. Just that one layer towards el centro. If you pull too hard here, you're going to rip the papel. And no lágrimas, no llorar, no crying if that happens. It's just tissue paper. We can certainly do this again, okay? It's not a disaster. It's going to be okay. You might have to try this a few times before you really make it pretty. It takes time to learn. Ejercicio hace el maestro, we say in Spanish. Practice makes perfect. And it doesn't have to be perfecto, remember? Muy bien. All right, so there we go. Now I'm going to go for my next layer. So that was my blanco in the middle. I'm going to pull that one up into the centro, to the center, on the other side too. Arriba al centro. Arriba al centro. Arriba al centro. I can kind of strike it like that, stroke it almost like a little perro. Oh, muy bien. Muy bien. Perfecto. No, solamente un nivel. One more layer. It's my pinkish layer. And I'm going to fold that up also into el centro. Gently, con mucho cuidado. And I can even squeeze a little bit down here so it stands up a little bit better. And now you have yourself a beautiful Mexican paper flor that we use for decoración for Cinco de Mayo. But I'll tell you a secret. And if one of the mamás, if you mamás are around right now, could I ask you to please just step outside of the room just for a moment? I'll wait until mamás have left. Are they gone? Okay. This is something that you can do for El Día de la Madre. You know, Mother's Day is coming up soon. And we mamás, we love this. You can make as many as you have tissue paper enough for. And you can go into mamá's baño and you can spray on a little perfume. And it turns out to the most beautiful Mother's Day present. So that's our little secreto. Just remember, in Mexico, we have tons of these for El Cinco de Mayo. I usually make a whole bouquet, and sometimes I give them away as a little present to my neighbors, my vecinos. Son muy bonitos. That's it for today. Desde la casa mía a la casa tuya, from my house to your house. Ciao!